मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव डन चैप्टर 5. नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 2 फर्स्ट, देन आफ्टर दैट वी विल डू चैप्टर नंबर 6. ओके, बिकॉज़ इनवर्स ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक नॉलेज इज रिक्वायर्ड. आई हैव एक्सप्लेन वन एक्सरसाइज इन चैप्टर 5 आल्सो रिलेटेड टू दिस चैप्टर इनवर्स ट्रिग्नोमेट्री, बट यू मस्ट नो अबाउट द इनवर्स ट्रिग्नोमेट्री बिफोर वी प्रोसीड the chapter 6, 7, 8 further. It is a very simple chapter. Chapter number 2, inverse trigonometric function. Chapter number 2, in short, I will write down inverse I trigonometric function, ITF. We will do inverse trigonometric function. As we have studied, inverse of the function f denoted by f inverse like this. In the first chapter, we have studied inverse of function f, how to calculate the inverse of the function. And there we have studied how to write down the inverse function. Okay. And before we calculate the inverse of function, what is required to check inverse function is required first. First of all, we have to check function whether it is 1-1 onto or not. Only those function which are 1-1 and onto have their inverse only. It means for inverse, it is the first condition the function should be 1-1 and onto. In this regard, first of all, we will discuss about the table through which we will find out what is the domain range of the given function. Suppose it is a sine x, cos x, because we are talking about a trigonometric functions, inverse of trigonometric function. So we will discuss sine, cos, tangent, cotangent, secant and cosecant. What is the domain and range of the given trigonometric function? As it is given in the chapter on the first page, basic concept. It means what is the domain and range you must know about the function. If you know about the trigonometric function, suppose that is sine x, its domain is R, and what is the range of this function? The value always lying between minus 1 to 1. Cos x, its domain is again real number, and domain range is also minus 1 to 1, closed interval. If I talk about tangent x, then domain is again real numbers. All trigonometric functions have domain R. Okay, then its range will be R, but here you have to remember, because sine x upon cos x, one condition must you have to remember about it, because cos x should not be equal to 0. So what? R minus those values which make the function not defined. These are the values like this. X is equal to 2n plus 1 into pi by 2, where n belongs to integers. This is the domain of the tangent. Because you have to remember it, cos x should not be equal to 0. And it goes up to the real number, means range will be real number. Now for the cot, again, cot x, the function is given, then that is cos x upon sin x. It means what? This should not be equal to 0. So domain will be what? R minus those values which make the function not defined. And pi and n is belonging to integers. And its range again is R. Now, if I talk about secant, its domain is secant. If I talk about secant function, then its domain will be r minus x of function values x is equal to 2n plus 1 into pi by 2 and belongs to z, because 1 upon secant x is what? 1 upon cos x. Cos should not be equal to 0. It means these values should be accepted from it. And domain to range. Range will be what? Value of this will lie in the interval this one. Real number minus this will be real number minus open interval minus 1 to 1. Okay. For cosecant, the value of domain is r minus, value should not be what? Sine should not be equal to 0. And pi should not be there and belongs to integer. And this will be the curly bracket and range will be r minus open interval minus 1 to 1. This is the table where we have studied what is the domain and range of the domain and range of trigonometric function. But what are the values when we talk about inverse of the trigonometric function? If the function is 1, 1 and 1, 2, then only we can find out the inverse of the function. So what you have to do, as you know that when I calculate values in 11th class, we have drawn the graph of the sine x, cos x, tangent x. As you know, if I take sine 0, then the value is 0. At 180, it is again 0. At 360, it is again 0. If I take, suppose 45, the value is 1 by root 2. And if I take 135, again it is 1 by root 2. It means what? If sine, suppose we were discussing about sine. If sine is 0, if you are taking domain, I'm talking about domain and you are getting range here. Domain, if x is, you are putting 0, then you are getting 0 here value. If you are putting 45, suppose 45, you are getting value root 3 by, 1 by root 2. 1 by root 2 at 45. And again at 135, the value will be again 1 by root 2. At 135, it is also 1 by root 2. Suppose I will take 60. What is sine 60? Sine 60 is root 3 by 2. Sine 60, root 3 by 2. If I take at the place of 60, I take 120, suppose. Then again, value will be root 3 by 2 or not? Yes, it is 1 by root 3 by 2 at 120. Okay. So, whether you can check it, function is 1, 1 or on 2? No, function is not 1, 1 and on 2. Because at 0 is 0, at pi is 0. 45, you're getting 1 by root 2. At 135, you're again getting 1 by root 2. It means function 1, 1 means if each and every element of set A has its image and unique image in set B. If it is onto, it means B has its pre-image in set A and both will be unique. So what to do to make the function 1, 1 and onto in the trigonometric form? You have to restrict the intervals. You have to restrict the intervals. If I take interval restriction, then if I take minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 domain, suppose I'm talking about sine. If I restrict sine x, sine function, if I restrict this function for the interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. If domain is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, then it becomes, the function becomes, function becomes 1 1 on 2. If I restrict it not in the interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, if I restrict it from minus for sorry my, 3 pi by 2 to minus pi by 2, again the function becomes 1 1 and on 2. Suppose I take minus pi by then minus my sorry pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2, suppose pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2, again function is 1 1 and its range is minus 1 to 1. It means what? If I want to make the function 1 1 on 2, I have to restrict the domain of the given trigonometric function, then it becomes 1 1 on 2 and you can find out the inverse of the function. So if we restricted all the trigonometric function and we got the function becomes 1 1 on 2, then what type of interval you have to take and which interval is known as the principal value interval, you have to learn it. Let's discuss a table. In the sine inverse case, table is sine inverse function. If function is sine inverse, then its domain is minus 1 to 1 and range will be equal to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. At this, we have taken only one interval. I have told you, you can restrict lot of intervals, but here I am taking the principal interval. If I talk about only principal values, we will go in the interval which is given in the table. For the cos inverse, the domain is again minus 1 to 1 and range will be equal to close interval 0 to pi. For the cosecant inverse, for the cosecant inverse, the domain is real numbers minus those numbers which make the function not defined or subtracted, and range you are getting the value minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Close interval, only 0 is accepted. Accept the value 0. Secant inverse. The table is r minus minus 1 to 1 and range will be equal to close interval 0 to pi and the value pi by 2 is should not be there. For the tangent inverse, r is the domain and the range will be equal to open interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. For the cot inverse, the range will be domain will be r and range will be open interval 0 to pi. These intervals you have to cram, or you can say remember these, all these values, then only you can find out the principal value of the given function. Let's do few questions related to this concept. I have told you, I have given the table which are just principal value table. So if the question is, suppose example number first is there. Here, find the principal value of, find principal value of sine inverse 1 by root 2. Not difficult, very easy to find out. Just practice is required to do question. Let y is equal to sine inverse 1 by 2. If you simplify it, you take sine both side. Sine y will be equal to 1 by root 2. The sine, taking sine both side. Sine and sine inverse, both are cancelled. Okay. When it is 1 by root 2, sine y is 1 by root 2 means the value of sine. When it is 1 by root 2? At 45. Pi by 4. So what? Y will be equal to pi by 4. Therefore, the principal value of what is this? Y is equal to sine inverse 1 by root 2. And you calculated it, y is equal to pi by 4. So principal value will be equal to pi by 4. You have to check, just check whether pi by 4 belongs to the interval. What is the interval? Minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. If it belongs to this, it means this is a principal value. Okay. Now come to the example number second. Suppose it's, next example is given. Example number 2. Find the principal value of cot inverse 1 by root 3. Let y is equal to cot inverse 1 upon root 3. Here minus sign is there, I think. Okay. Okay. So cot of y is equal to 1 upon root 3 with minus sign. Okay. Now you can write it as like this: cot of y is equal to minus of cot 1 by root 3 is at 1, that is pi by 3. Now you have to write the question so that the interval of cot range is given, that is 0 to pi interval. Question value will be lying in this, then it is a principal value, otherwise not. I can write it like this, that is cot of pi minus pi by 3, because you know that in the 11th class, what cot is negative? Where cot is negative? Where cot is negative? In the second quadrant, cot is negative. You can say pi minus theta. That's why I have written pi minus pi by 3. That is cot of 2 pi by 3. Now you have to check whether this 2 pi by 3 belongs to this 0 to pi or not. What is 2 pi by 3 means what? 120. And it is 0 to 180, it means what? 2 pi by 3 belongs to it, but y is equal to 2 pi by 3. If it is, it doesn't belong to the interval, it means you have to make the conversion like this. It will lie in the interval, otherwise that will not be the principal value. So what, y is 2 pi by 3? So what you can say, y is 2 pi by 3 and y is given cot inverse minus 1 by root 3. So what, when you replace this y by 2 pi by 3, it means the answer of principal value of this cot inverse minus 1 upon root 3 is 2 pi by 3. This will be the answer. Let's do few more questions. Let's do questions. Do question number first. Read the statement. What is the statement of the question number first? Write down. Question is, find the principal value of sine inverse. Write down the question. Principal value, you have to find out sine inverse minus 1 by 2. Minus 1 by 2. Now you have to simplify it. Let y is equal to sine inverse minus half sine y, taking sine both side, minus half, and sine y is equal to, when it is minus half, taking minus and outside, when it is half at pi by 6. It is at pi by 6. Okay. Now tell me, what is the interval for sine? That is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Okay. Now, question is, how to write now the statement minus of sine pi by 6? When sine is negative, just tell me. In these two quadrants, the sine is negative. When I convert the function in this interval, it will not lie in the interval, this minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So, if I convert in the interval, this one fourth quadrant, it will come from this side, because interval is about 0 to pi by 2 and 0 to minus pi by 2, like this. If I write this statement like this in for the fourth quadrant, I can write like this, minus of pi by 6 sine y, and y will be equal to minus pi by 6. If y is minus pi by 6, it's the principal value of sine inverse minus half is equal to minus pi by 6. Okay. Let's do question number. Suppose it is question number next, second. Question number fifth. Let's do question number fifth. Statement is, question number fifth is, find the principal value of the function. Principal value of the function, that is, suppose y is equal to statement cos inverse minus 1 by 2. Find principal value. So what cos of y will be equal to? Minus half. When it is minus half, cos of y minus cos of pi by 3. And the interval for the cos is 0 to pi. Which you have to remember it. Whenever you are solving the question, you have table in your mind always. Only then you can find the correct principal value. So what the cos will be having interval 0 to pi. You must remember it. Now 0 to pi. You have to convert, apply the conversion on it. Then pi by 3 with minus and cos. It means it can be written as cos of pi minus pi by 3 in the second quadrant. Cos is negative. You can write cos of pi minus theta is equal to minus cos theta. So what? It becomes cos of 2 pi by 3. Now you have to check whether this 2 pi by 3 belongs to this interval or not. Yes, it belongs to this interval. So what? This is a principal value. So y will be equal to 2 pi by 3, or you can say it equal to cos inverse minus of half. This is the answer. Okay. Suppose you have to do the question number 11. How to do the question number 11? Write down the statement. Question number 11. That is, write down the question number 11. Write down the statement. That statement is sine inverse 1. No, sine is 1. Tangent inverse 1, sorry. Question number 11. That is tangent inverse 1 plus cos inverse minus half plus sine inverse minus 1 by 2. How to get the value? Now I left you this question for you. Just check. Find out the principal value of the first, principal value of the second, principal value of the third, as I told you in the previous phase. Find out the principal values. As I have calculated, tangent inverse 1 will be equal to, it gives you the principal value, that will be pi by 4. That will be pi by 4. And this will be pi minus pi by 3. That will be 2 pi by 3. And this will be equal to minus of pi by 6. I have told you. Now simply, you have to simplify all three parts separately and put the values here. So this becomes 2 pi by 3 minus pi by 6, and you are getting, this is equal to, taking LCM, what you will get? Take the LCM and you will get the, this is pi by 4, pi by 3, pi by 6, that is 12 is LCM, 3 pi plus 8 pi minus 2 pi. You are getting 11 minus 2 pi, 9 pi upon 12, 3 4 is a 3, 3 is a 3 pi by 4 is the answer. Okay, now you can do exercise 2.1. 2.2 is not in our syllabus. You have to try few questions of miscellaneous which are in syllabus. You have to do those questions only in which you have to find out the principal value only. Do those questions only, otherwise 2.2 is not in our syllabus. Just one or two questions are there in miscellaneous which you have to do. I think first question, find the value, that you have to do. Otherwise, formula based questions are not in your syllabus. Now do chapter 2, exercise 2.1 and 2 or 3 questions of miscellaneous. And you have to go through this chapter for the MCQ questions. I think this is now the important chapter for the MCQ part. MCQ questions you have to do. Okay. Thank you. Have a nice day.